Good day, everyone. This is Alvin again from the Philippines, and welcome to another episode of Will Win, Will Not Win. And today, we will be talking about on why South Africa's Natasha Joubert will win Miss Universe 2020. Welcome to episode 5 of Will Win, Will Not Win segment in my channel. This episode 5 features South Africa's Natasha Joubert. I have already uploaded the first 4 episodes featuring Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, and India. All episodes are already available on my YouTube channel, so you can just go ahead and check them out if you haven't seen them yet. And I suggest you do, so that you will be able to understand the reasons on why I think they will win and why I think they will not win Miss Universe 2020. This is the first part of the 2-part series. I will also be posting its counterpart, which is why South Africa's Natasha Joubert will not win Miss Universe 2020. So be sure to check that out as well. Now, South Africa already won 3 crowns in Miss Universe. First in 1978 with Margaret Gardner, followed by 2017 Demi Lee Nell Peters, and 2019 Zozibini Tunzi. This year, South Africa is aiming not only for a back-to-back, but for their 4th Miss Universe crown. Now, why Natasha will win Miss Universe 2020? Number 1, she's the best of the best. I am talking about how she was selected in the national pageant. I have always been very vocal on how I admire Miss South Africa as a national pageant, because they always choose the best of the best every year, to the point that their national pageant is a bloodbath by itself, because of the high caliber candidates competing. Seeing Natasha emerge from a very competitive 2020 batch just proved her overall caliber as a contender. Next, strong team. Well, with Werner being part of the Miss South Africa, who is responsible for South Africa's rise in different pageants, especially in Miss Universe, I am 100% confident that Natasha will come strong and will defend the crown in the best way she and her team can. Followed by number 3, strong caliber as a contender. This is in connection to number 1, being one of the strongest competitors not only in Miss South Africa but now in Miss Universe. Natasha is definitely on her way again to bring South Africa on top, because she has already showed so many improvements in the last few days, and she is consistently strong as always. One of the assets of a Miss South Africa is being a strong speaker, and Natasha, based on her national pageant, obviously will deliver strongly in that area. Now, let's discuss her road to victory, her road for a back-to-back crown for South Africa in Miss Universe. Natasha is not only one of the strongest candidates overall, but in the regional selection of Miss Universe, I can also say that she's one of the strongest, undoubtedly, in Asia Pacific and Africa. I see no reason for Natasha to be in the wild card, because she is a solid, strong contender to get one of the spots in Asia Pacific and African region. Having said that, this gives her, I believe, a 100% assurance that she will be in the top 20. In the top 20 speech, being a strong speaker, I can also see her dominate at this round, which will give her a ticket to perform in the top 10. In the top 10 round, we have already seen how much risk did the Miss South Africa organization and team did last year with Zozibini. And I have read a post from Werner before, days ago or weeks ago, I just cannot point out the specific date. I hope I remembered it correctly, that they are already working on Natasha's dress for Miss Universe, and I am so excited at what they're going to prepare for her, because her team will definitely do their best to elevate what they did last year with Zozie. If Natasha and her team could give us another jaw-dropping moment in the top 10, I can see her go all the way to the top 5. And finally, again, going back to her strength as a public speaker and how she promotes entrepreneurship and empowerment of women, Natasha could possibly be unstoppable as well once she reached the top 5 and top 3. And if she will give a much stronger response in this round, then I wouldn't mind a back-to-back victories for South Africa, because it will most likely happen. Knowing her caliber as a contender, they need to watch out for Natasha, because once she enters the top 5 or top 3, there's really very, very small ways of stopping her of getting that back-to-back round for her country. And this is why South Africa's Natasha Joubert will win Miss Universe 2020. So what do you think? Don't forget to watch as well the follow-up video on why I think South Africa's Natasha Joubert will not win Miss Universe 2020. So be sure to check that one. And what do you think? Do you agree that South Africa could potentially pull a back-to-back placement for her country? What do you think? Based on your own personal assessment, if you could write down in the comment section the percentage of her winning a back-to-back, what do you think is that percentage? Do you think is her chance of winning a back-to-back? Don't forget to leave your comments below. Don't forget to give a thumbs up and share the video as well. And most importantly, don't forget to subscribe, because you'll be seeing more of these videos in the future. For now, thank you very much and have a wonderful day from the Philippines.